Note, although this video is based on real history, this animation contains elements of fantasy. There are some exaggerations in how some situations being presented, but they are real history. And such exaggerations are my point of view, and I hope these are not offensive. Thank you. You may now enjoy the video. Europe had had enough. It is now war. Brutal war. New countries with different thoughts have now started to emerge at the end of this war. It would change the world forever. Austria-Hungary invaded Bosnia. This angered the Russians, who wanted control in the area, and the Serbians as well. But then, the French invaded Morocco just after they had a revolution. And this angered another country which had been at war with them previously, and this was Germany. Germany wanted to rule the world, and they thought if France continued to expand, Germany would suffer and wouldn't achieve their results. And Britain was keen on keeping its empire. And Britain saw Germany as a threat to its interests. When Britain had attacked the Boers in South Africa, Germany had opposed to this. And Britain was extremely angry at Germany ever since. And now they went into a naval arms race in where they tried to arm more than each other, and this really damaged both sides' economies. All of this meant that the Europeans allied with nations that shared their interests. In 1904, the Entente Cordiale was signed between Britain, France, and Russia, and Austria-Hungary, Germany, and Italy had also signed a pact together. The Austro-Hungarian Empire was falling apart. It was losing its grip on all of the nations that were in its empire. This included Bosnia, which it had just conquered. Hungary all wanted independence. That is why Archduke Franz Ferdinand wanted to introduce some reforms to make Bosnians feel more like Austrians, so that they would love benefiting to their community. The visit to Sarajevo was going fine, but the couple was worried. This was because Nedeljko Kobrinović had thrown a grenade at them, but he was later arrested. The worried authorities decided to change the route of the royal car. Unfortunately, they forgot to inform the driver, and this meant the worst of all. Sophie, Archduke Franz Ferdinand's wife, had died immediately because the bullet had hit where she was pregnant. Archduke Franz Ferdinand was hit in his jugular vein, and this meant he died very quickly as well, because this vein was the vein that connected the heart to the other parts of the body. But more importantly, the weapons had come from Serbia, and Austria-Hungary declared war on Serbia for this offense. The Russians had an alliance with the Serbians. They agreed to protect them, and so they mobilized their troops. Germany was furious. They had an alliance with Austria, and they tried to get Russia to stop mobilizing, but Russia completely ignored the threat. Germany then declared war on Russia. And so, Austria-Hungary and Germany were at war with Russia, and France was determined to join. The Germans began to make plans for the war. General Schlieffen had made a plan in 1904, but he had later retired. Helmuth von Moltke was then put in charge of the army. He believed that the defenses near Russia should be stronger. Chancellor Theobald believed a quick victory would solve political divides in the country, and so he was keen in making his choice wise. He wanted to win. Kaiser Wilhelm II was completely overconfident and imagined that the French would fall very quickly. But he was keen on defending the east of Germany, as he believed Austria-Hungary would be powerless. That's why he went with Helmuth's decision. For the current allies, France and Russia, the plan was easy. Since France and Russia were on both sides of Germany, if Germany attacked France, which was the more likely plan actually, then Russia would come in from the east, immediately attack East Prussia. If Germany was to attack Russia, then France would come in from the west, launching Plan 17 and deteriorating Germany. But the result could be different. When the Germans reached France, things started to change. The Germans were confronted by many British and French troops, and they seriously halted the military's progress. And one battle would test the survival of the Schlieffen Plan. Battle of Marne marked the end of 1914, and it really stalled the Germans. The Schlieffen Plan had completely gone bust. People lost their legs and arms. It was truly gruesome. But with Helmuth von Moltke's plan, there were more soldiers in East Prussia, and these went on to attack Poland along with Austria-Hungary, and was crushed. Huh?
The Axis began steady advancements in the Eastern Front. It was much better than the Western Front. But something unexpected was emerging in the Southern Front.
The Italians had joined the war on the Allies' side. This was inconceivable. This didn't make sense. The Italians had a treaty with the Austro-Hungarians and the Germans called the Triple Alliance, and they were supposed to fight together against the Allies. But Italy had remained neutral, then changed sides. A traitor. Then the Allies decided to invade the Ottoman Empire so they could capture Istanbul and then ship resources to Russia. Would this go well, or would it be true horror for the Allied troops and for the Axis troops? First, the British commenced naval bombardments on Gallipoli, and during these bombardments, much was damaged, including wagons that carried shells to the cannons. Since cannons can move, well, since they were stationed in forts, you need wagons to carry shells to the cannons, and or else you couldn't fire the cannon. But the Ottomans had a hero.
Hadi yapabilirsin!
Afiyet asker, senin sayende İngiliz gemisini biraz hasar vermişiz uzaklarda. Hadi bakalım, yeniden. Evet, gemiden duman çıkıyor, hasar verdik. Gemiden de duman çıkıyor, ona da hasar verilmiş başka bir top tarafından. Bunlar niye çok yakınmıştı? Evet, bunların ne işi var?
The Allies deployed their armies. The British also deployed ANZACs, Australia and New Zealand Army Corps. Fire!
Let's go!
Turks were defending their lands, unlike the Germans, which were invading other lands. And the Turks fell as heroes. Badly manufactured weapons soon broke down, The Turks soon had to use other sorts of weapons. This didn't stop them. They carried on to victory, and they sacrificed their lives. Few Germans were fighting along with the Turks at Gallipoli, and most of them were generals. They were ordering all of them to use their own tactics. Germans didn't know Gallipoli, but they were still ordering the Turks to do what they said. And General Mustafa Kemal strongly opposed to this, and he used his own tactics. And they would prove much better than the German tactics, since they would succeed and lead the Turks to victory. Unlike the Germans' most allies, the Ottomans cured their adversaries, and they returned them to where they were loved. This made Britain view them as honorable warriors. General Mustafa Kemal's plan had succeeded, and the British had run away! This marked a very successful 1915 to the Axis. It is not easy to decide the victor of the Battle of Verdun, this deadly battle that started 1916, ended with great casualties and losses from both sides. Then, later that year, the Austro-Hungarians declared war on Romania in hope of regaining land since their empire was falling apart. In 1917, the Germans introduced unrestricted submarine warfare, which meant sinking down any ship trying to help the Allies, even if it was not an ally nation, which meant sinking American ships. And this meant that America might join the war, so Foreign Minister Arthur Zimmerman needed to find a way to distract America. Could it be economic crisis? But how would he do that? It was impossible. Could it be military invasion? And so Arthur Zimmerman considered every single possibility until he reached the point that possibly Mexico could declare war on America to distract them. Hey, watch out, son! Where are you going?
Sir,
here's my master plan. We're gonna get Mexico to invade America. Yeah.
Well, now, how are you gonna do that?
I'm gonna send the German ambassador in Mexico a telegraph! Yes, and it'll work.
Sir, we have intercepted a message going from Berlin to New Mexico. It is from Arthur Zimmerman, the foreign minister of the German Empire. He's trying to get Mexico into the war. He's trying to get it to declare war on America. What can we do? This is a crisis. We must inform this to America immediately. We should not worry. The war shall be stopped. The invasion shall be stopped. The Germans will not be able to expand the war.
The President of the United States was shocked to see that the Germans would do such a thing. He invited Zimmerman to deny that he did this. But smart old Zimmerman told the truth. And so, America declared war on Germany. They took part on the Allies, and of course, by doing so. But this did not stop Zimmerman's very smart plans. This time, the problem was the Russians. He needed to get rid of them. Zimmerman knew that if he could get Vladimir Lenin to cause a revolution in Russia, he might be able to cause enough instability for the Russians to get out of the war. So he gave Lenin enough money to travel there. In February, Tsar was already overthrown, but not by communists. A provisional government had been created. Very few were killed, maybe one or two broken limbs. And the Tsar was shot. And then
Lenin came along.
The revolution was a success. Well, firstly it was a failure, then Lenin escaped Finland, but then he came back and then he succeeded, yes! And Russia became Soviet Russia. Raw! At the time of the provisional government, there was the Duma, which was non-communist. There were also the Soviets, which were communists, and Lenin gave these people all power.
Doing this, he was shot.
But he survived! And then he went into quite a bonanza! He launched a civil war, and he also declared war on Poland.
Yeah. 1918 was basically failure after failure for the Axis. They deteriorated. The Germans then commenced a mutiny, so they refused to fight and killed their generals. And Germany soon surrendered to the Allies.